Source person of the day, Mr. Sameer Joshi, who holds a degree in polymer engineering along with holding a degree on waste management. He has been working in plastics waste management and has been supporting young entrepreneurs who are dedicated to reduce plastic pollution. He is fellow of Indian Plastics Institute and of Indian Institute of Valuers, member institution of Engineers India, and senior member Society of Plastic Engineers US. He holds expertise in circular economy, recycling, EPR and plastics, and has his own plastic injection molding unit in Pune. Mr. Sameer Joshi is an approved valuer for plant machinery and honorable treasurer, governing council of Indian Plastics Institute and head of Plastics Committee Material Recycling Association of India. Along with all these multiple feats, he also holds a Guinness World Book record for the world's largest t-shirt from plastic waste, which was manufactured in 2018. He is a member and associated with a lot of associations. If I kind of make a list, start reading them, it would take a pretty long time, but still I would like to mention a few very significant ones. He's Member Advisory Committee, CIPET, Department of Chemicals and Petrochemicals, Government of India, Member CSR Committee, Associum India, Member Industry Academia Committee, MIT University, Signatory to Global Commitment to End Plastic Waste, Member Global Partnership, etc. There's a never-ending list of all his accomplishments, and I invite you over, sir, for your wonderful talk, which we are eagerly waiting for.
Namaskar, everybody. Thank you for having me. And with that kind of introduction, I think even my wife will not recognize me.
No, sir. It's all there in your accomplishments. We are so very proud of your achievements, sir.
Thank you. May I request the presentation to be displayed? I sent it by email.
Yes, sir. We are sharing it.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Neetu. Can you
please proceed.
On this day of a wonderful day, I come with an agenda that is a little different. The environment and justice. How do we go from here? Next, please.
Next slide.
Tipping Point, that is the cover story of the first issue of Jan 2020 of the magazine called Geographical, which is a very old publication dating back to 1935, says that the garbage crisis will be a global challenge for all of us and will stay with us for this decade. And it is time for all of us to act. How we have seen the growth of a pandemic. The pandemic which has begun with a small virus. 1/10,000 the size of a full stop. It has put a pause to our life, our vision, our mission. All was going through well. But perhaps, you know, that virus is also because of our bad habits, our habits of disturbing the environment. Next, please.
Next you need, right?
Some wise people have said to live the world better than you found it. Sometimes you have to pick up other people's trash. How true it is. An American citizen in his lifetime generates 102 tons of garbage. The garbage is going to be a global phenomenon that is going to haunt us for times to be. And we should look at this waste not as waste, but try and reduce our consumption and our acts so that we do not put a burden on our resources. Next, please. Every year, India produces 9.25 million tons of plastic waste. That is almost equivalent to 771 times the Taj Mahal and 600 times by weight the Qutub Minar. It is time to ponder and reflect on how much waste is created by the use of plastic, which is littered by our country, fellow citizens. Next, please. Cleanliness. See how one citizen littering, the second citizen littering, the third citizen littering, and oh, everyone is saying, don't be the first person to litter, how bad it is. It all begins with you and me. Next, please. We talk of a new normal in this times of pandemic. On one side, we have the consumer-driven factors. On the other side, our laws and our regulations, which bring a balance on health and hygiene. And we talk about a sustainability effort in all our resources. Health and hygiene, packaging, this is on topmost priority at the moment, what we are going through. We have the artificial intelligence and smart packaging that is coming in. We have to be responsible consumers in not littering the packaging that we create after the use of the product. We have to find the waste solutions, the recycling solutions. We have to have a conscious note of our ecological footprint and how we act and behave with our water and our air pollution. Next, please. This is the gamut of solid waste, municipal solid waste, the electronic waste, hazardous waste, the construction and demolition waste, the plastic waste, the biomedical waste, the industrial waste. Laws have been formulated by the government of India way back, and they were modified in 2016. And one has to strike a balance with the waste and the resources and the residues and their emissions. It is like creating wealth from waste. We should not look at waste as a waste, but as a resource to recycle and find opportunities. The waste warriors, as we call them during the pandemic, they have kept our cities and our towns clean, and they have contributed us towards our safety and our hygiene. Next, please. This is a wonderful product from waste, a robot, a humanoid inspired by the Digital India Mission. A computer science teacher, Dinesh Patel, in the Mumbai Kendriya Vidyalaya of IIT Bombay, developed a Indian robot, Shalu. It is made from 100% waste material, utilizing discarded plastic, cardboard, wood, and aluminium parts. The robo not just resembles a woman, but speaks like one. It can greet people, display emotions. Shalu, as it is, she is called, possesses a broad range of skills, which includes recognizing people's faces and can speak 38 languages. What a wonderful piece of work from what we call as a waste. Next, please. All human species are interdependent. So taking care of our shared resources is essential so that human prosperity can coexist with the conservation goals. When we talk of justice, when we talk of environment, it is eco versus ego, the human ego versus the eco that the world has given us. Next, please. As I mentioned, ego, the human ego, which destroys the Mother Earth and the ecology, which we are all part of the system. We have to have a conscious effort to balance our acts and our actions. Next, please. We know how everyone curses plastics, but it was that same unpopular plastic turned savior in the fight against the pandemic. The mask, the protective gear, the injections that are part of the vaccine, they are all there to save us. One must ensure that we do not litter those plastics. Plastics and those masks have not come there by themselves in those oceans or in the garbage dumps. They have been littered. And one must make a conscious effort to not discard or litter what we just use and throw. There is a wise saying, plastics do not litter, people do. We have to be very conscious of this fact that if we discard or litter the used plastics that has been used for the fight against the pandemic, no one is going to be affected more than us in some form or the other. Next, please. India leads by example. 72 nations have adopted the indoors waste to energy model. The Bhopal's plastic recycling model is showcased at the World Bank headquarters. So India leads by example. The Swachh Bharat mission launched by our Honorable Prime Minister in 2014 has come a long way and also have protected our citizens from various illnesses which were earlier there. One has to make a conscious effort to balance our acts and not create problems for the environment, whereby justice will demand and it will not forgive anyone. No justice at the cost of creating nuisance to the environment. Next, please. This is a slide which I had from my latest visit to Leh Ladakh, a company by the name of Planet First. They are empowering the waste pickers there and collecting the littered plastics. Look at their tagline, planet, people, profit, and then comes plastics. We have to keep this in mind. We are here because of the planet. The planet does not need us. We need this planet. No doubt, we are here to make a good life. But if we disturb our nature, then justice will never forgive us. Next, please. India produces 277.1 million tons of solid waste every year. That is likely to touch a whopping 387.8 million tons in 2030. At 277.1 million tons, India generates more than 80% of what South India produces and 13% of the global waste annually. Next, please. There is a moving story, a two-line story. A son and his father are walking on the beach. The father says to his son, son, do you know why this lady is picking up garbage at the beach? Because she doesn't have the proper education. The wise son of today, who is very well aware of what is going on, says, Dad, she is picking up garbage at the beach because we don't have the education. She is not the garbage generator. She is the garbage warrior. We are the garbage generator. Change. We must change ourselves and everything will change for a better tomorrow. Next, please. The Green Tribunal, the National Green Tribunal, has directed the Union Territories and the states and the cities to manage the solid waste that is generated. That the local bodies would need to pay fines if this rule is not followed. The courts, the justice of these lands are very much concerned about our environment. And it is not they who will just order. It is for all of us. We have to respect our environment. And no one will ever forgive us if we abuse our environment. Next, please. Coming to today's day, justice. Justice also for the environment. Environment justice is the fair treatment and meaningful involvement of all people, regardless of race, color, national origin, or income, with a respect to development, implementation, and enforcement of environmental laws, regulations, and policies. This environmental justice confirms the right to a healthy and a safe working environment without having to choose between unemployment and unsafe source of livelihood. No justice will ever say that work in an unethical and unsafe environment. It also confirms that those who work from home have a right of freedom from environmental hazards. That is the beauty, that is the greatness of the environmental justice, which plays an important role in our lives. We talk about justice in various forms. Have we ever thought and pondered about this word, the environmental justice for you and me and for our better planet? Next, please. A thought before I close. We always overestimate the changes that will occur in the next 2 years and underestimate the change will occur in the next 10. We are all progressing, and we have forgotten our basic rules, our basic ethics, our basic efforts for a positive environment. We have overlooked that, and look what we have landed in, this pandemic situation, which is taking us back instead of ahead. And it has spared no one on this earth. Next, please. As I conclude, we have to look at environment and have justice for that. And that will come only with our own efforts. It's ultimately a balance of environment and our justice to our planet Earth. Thank you and namaskar.